शंकराचार्य मध्यमा अस्मदाचार्य वंदे गुरु परंपरा श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने धूमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विदाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तदुम्भदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणं प्रपद्ये। शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्री चित् घन गणेश नमो मह्यम सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामं पि अधिष्ठानं बुद्धि बोध्यं बुद्धे पारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक् परम तदेव मे निश्चिता मतिः। मार्क दिस जस्ट वांटेड टू मेंशन समथिंग अबाउट दिस मंत्र फ्रॉम बृहदारण्यक उपनिषद। ब्रह्म तम परादात यो अन्यत्रात्मना ब्रह्म वेद एंड देन देर इज अ सीक्वेंस काइंड ऑफ अ रिफ्रेन देर क्षत्रम तम परादात एटसेट्रा एंड देन एंडिंग विद सर्वम तम परादात यह अन्यत्र आत्मना सर्वम वेद। सो आई जस्ट वांटेड टू मेक अ मेंशन हियर दिस ब्रह्म शब्द इज ब्राह्मण जाति। So yesterday I said Brahma. Generally, when you see Brahma, the word is used in multiple senses. One is Nirguna Brahma, other is Saguna Brahma Ishvara, which is what we saw here. Then as Brahmana also, and when declined in masculine, it also becomes Brahma, Chaturmukha Brahma. Brahma is also used for Vedas. So thereby we have to see which meaning. So we, since we are in the context of Vedanta and just now we have gone through this, we are looking at Chaitanya, especially Chaitanya. So I thought that it is Brahma as we know as Chid Brahma, but I had to cross check because the meaning was a little lost on me. Although it is in the context of Advaita Tattva being the focus and Dvaita being refuted, because we saw that Mrityasya Mrityum Apnoti, Udaramantam Kurute, etc. But Brahmatam Parada, there mantra says Brahmana Jati, then Kshatram, Kshatriya Jati, and so on till Sarvam. What it means is that, and Parada Tayat says Parakuryat, so one should keep it away. That is the meaning there. So, would or should keep it away? If we take it as a vidhi, then should, parakuryat. And it can also be, since vidhiling, it can also have the meaning of would. So, would, should, both meanings are okay. Brahmana jati would keep the person, tam. Who is that? Yaha, yaha anyatra atmanaha. Brahma meaning Brahmana jati veda. The Brahma there stands for Brahmana Jati. So Brahmana Yaha Brahmana Jatim Atmanaha Anyatra Veda Tam Brahmana Jati Eva Paradat. Because Brahmana Jati or Kshatriya Jati or any Jati or anything, then landing with Sarvam, anything and everything is nothing but manifestation of same Brahma. Therefore, one who thinks that Atma. So here, not Chid Brahma and Atma Bheda, although that is also there, but then in this context, what is being said is anything and everything should be seen as one with one Swarupa, which is Brahmatma. There Brahma is not Chid Brahma, but there Brahmana Jati. And landing with each and every Jati, each and everything, till you get Sarvam, Sarvam Khalvidam, Atma there, not Brahma, Sarvam Khalvidam, Atma, which is Brahma Bhinna. Thereby, anything that you separate from yourself would reject you. That is the idea there. So I just wanted to clarify that. Okay. Further, we finish the 187th avarta. Jiva Brahmano Laksharta Bheda Sambhava Aham Brahma Iti Janiyat Iti Guru Rupadesha. Since Jiva and Brahma, Laksharta is same Chit Brahma, Chaitanya, Kutasya Chaitanya on the Jiva side and Brahma Chaitanya comparable to Mahakasha on the Brahma side, therefore Abheda is possible. Not only possible, Bheda is impossible really. Therefore, Aham Brahma iti Janiyat. One should know oneself as Brahma. Iti Guru Rupadeshaha. This is the teaching of the Guru. He Somya, Tvatkrita Prashnadvaya Madhye Ekasmin Vrikshe Dau Pakshina Ustaha Tayoreko Bhokta Aparo Nirihaha Ataha Jiva Brahmaikyam Naghatate Iti Prathama Prashnaha. Your question was, the Dvasuparna mantra is talking about Bheda. It is not talking about Aikya, but Bheda. Therefore, you should consider these two Pakshis as different, and therefore Jiva and Ishvara as different. This is the question. This is a doubt raised by Tattva Drishti. In those two questions, the first one was relating to the mantra. One is Bhokta, the other is Niriha. Niriha is, Udasina or completely indifferent, unattached kind of a actionless, motionless Brahma. Ishvara otherwise. Ataha, Jiva Brahma Ekyam Na Ghatate. Jiva and Brahma Ekyam is not possible. Iti hi Prathama Prashna, the doubt raised there. Tatra evam samadhana muktam, and the samadhana was given earlier in 187th, eka vrukshastha pakshinor madhye eka kutastha apara buddhau pratiphalite siddhabhasa ityevam grahyam natu jiva paramatmanau natu jiva paramatmanau iti grahyam iti. So your consideration is wrong. You have misunderstood the birds as jiva and ishvara. However, one is siddhabhasa and the other is Kutastha Chaitanya. That was the answer given. Etayor Ghatakashasya Akasha Chayayascha Iva Bheda Iti Chauktam. Like the Ghatakasha and Akasha Chaya. That is the difference. So the difference is Upadhi Krita and the reflections vary, but the Bimba does not vary. That was the idea there. Tatkruta dvitiya prashna ritya na jiva karma upasanayo karta na pi ishvara tat phaladata. And karma and upasana wouldn't be possible unless there is bheda revealed by the Shruti. Otherwise, the karma upasana kanda in Vedas will become vyartha. To that, the answer was given. Upasana and karma karta is not jiva and phaladata is not ishvara, kintu tau chidabhasau eva. On both sides, there is chidabhasa, avidya pratibimbita, chidabhasa is the karta, and maya pratibimbita, chidabhasa is the phaladata, karma phaladata. Jiva gata abhasa amsha karma upasana adi karoti, ishvara gata abhasa amsha phalandadati. So the Aumsha out of the three in Jiva, Chaitanya, Shuddha Chaitanya Aumsha, Avidya or Buddhi Aumsha, or Antakkarana Aumsha, and the third one is the Pratiphalita Abhasa. That Abhasa in the Jiva Traya Aumsha, Aumsha Traya, the Chidabhasa Aumsha, Abhasa Aumsha is the Karta of Karma and Upasana, whereas Abhasa Aumsha in Ishvara, other than the Shuddha Chaitanya and Maya Upadhi, is the Karma Phaladata, Phalam Dadati. Jiveshwara Anugata Chaitanya Aumsha Stu, Ghatakasha Mahakashavat, Bheda Shunyaha. However, the Chaitanya Amsha in Jiva as well as Ishvara cannot be differentiated at all. It is Bheda Shunya, Itham Jiva Brahmanur Aikyam Siddhyati. So, Upadhi Tyagena, Bhagatyaga Lakshanena, Lakshanaya, Bhagatyaga Lakshanaya, what happens? You get the Aikya between Jiva Brahma. Ataha Aham Brahmasmi Ityevam Tvam Vijaniya. What remains is that Aham is the Pratyagatma, Shuddha Chaitanya, and Brahma is also Shuddha Chaitanya at the Samashti level. Vyashti and Samashti are Upadhi Bheda, Upadhi Krita Bheda. There is no Vyashti separate from Samashti. Shuddha Chaitanya is never divided. Iti evam tvam vijaniya. Atra aham shabdartha kutastha iti Brahma shabdartha mahakasha samataya ukta lakshyartha bhuta shuddha chaitanyam iti cha avehi. So aham shabdartha is kutastha because vachyartha is literal. Vachyartha is upadhi sahita chaitanya, which is called as chidabhasa when there is pratiphalana. Whereas the lakshyartha is kutastha, kutastha chaitanya, which is never ever affected by any flaws or punya papas of the upadhi. Brahma shabdartha, vachyartha is Ishvara, karma phaladata, srishti sthiti laya, srishti sthiti laya karana. Whereas Shuddha Chaitanya is the lakshyartha, therefore mahakasha samataya ukta lakshyartha bhuta Shuddha Chaitanyam iti chavehi. The mahakasha is the ghatakasha. Similarly, Brahma Chaitanya, which is the Shuddha Chaitanya, that alone is Kutastha Chaitanya also. Iti cha avehi, know it in that manner. Aham iti Brahma iti cha shabdayor vachyarthayor aikya sambhavepi lakshyarthayos tat siddhyati eva. And we have seen vachyartha, there is bheda in vachyartha, which is mithya. Vachyartha is mithya, therefore bheda is mithya. Whereas lakshyartha is not mithya, it is satya, and it is the only ekameva dvitiya padartha, which is the vastu, and that cannot have any differences. He somya yavat aham brahma iti aparoksha sakshat karaha tava dridataro na jayati tavat dukkha dainya bhayadikam tvam na jahati. Ohak tyage na jahati the dukkha dainya bhaya adi. None of these would give you up. They'll not do your tyaga. They'll hold on to you as very dear. As long as you do not have sakshatkara aparoksha jnana, aparoksha sakshatkara. And it should not be just doubtless, it should also be sthira, without any obstacles. Therefore, dhridatara, nishta should be there, nitaram sthiti. As long as that sakshatkara does not become sthira, aparoksha jnana, that I am Brahma, does not become sthira, so long the dukkha ityadi will continue. They will not give you up. Svasvarupad bhinnataya paramatmano jnanam evati bhayahetur bhavati. Paramatmanah jnanam eva is bhayahetu as well as sukahetu, anandahetu. This is elaborately discussed in Taittiriya Brahmana also, Taittiriya Upanishad. The same Ishvara being karma phaladata becomes a bhaya hetu if he is separate from yourself, is seen separate from yourself, because he is a karma phaladata. Being karma phaladata, he becomes a bhaya hetu for a papi. One who has done papa karma, everyone does some papa unknowingly. For that, there are prayaschitas on a daily basis. Prayaschita karma cannot be done completely, therefore papa will continue. One cannot take away all papa. So, papa will keep on continuing. Even for a jnani, earlier papa Papa, he may not do papa, but papa karma phala will continue to fructify in the form of bodily and emotional pain. As long as Ishwara is seen different, ajnani will continue to have bhaya. Whereas jnani, although there are papa phalas, dukkha ityadi, bhaya ityadi, they will not affect the jnani because he does not consider the Ishwara, he does not consider Ishwara as separate from oneself. Paramatmanaha jnanam, same jnana, how? Swaswarupad bhinnataya or ekataya. If bhinnataya, then bhaya hetur bhavati. And the same paramatma becomes abhaya karana also by cognitive shift, just by understanding ekataya paramatmanaha jnanam. Ekataya. Paramatma is one, and since he is one, I cannot be separate. I am one with him. Very simple, you know. Just if you work on the word eka also, it is simple. Not aikya between the two necessarily. Since there is eka tattva, I am that tattva. Because I know without any other proof that I am existent. Therefore, I cannot say I am not there. It would be foolish to make a statement like that. Therefore, and it's a meaningless statement. Since I already know that I am, and Shruti says there is eka tattva, then that tattva has to be me without knowing anything else. You don't need the Shrishti, you don't need Ishwara, you don't need all this. If the Shraddha in the Shruti is complete and one has some Viveka, as this Prapancha is not there in Swapna, my Swapna Anubhava is as Drada as the Jagrat Anubhava, thereby there is no way to say which is real. Both are mithya. And since both are mithya, what is the real existent tattva? I know that I am existent. Is there anyone who is giving me all these experiences? Yes, that Shruti reveals as eka tattva. That eka tattva has to be me because I know that I exist. With or without the avasthas. So, swaswarupa bhinnataya paramatmano jnanam. Te bhaya hetu, tava, te stava for you. Te bhaya heturu bhavati. Why so? Udaram antaram kurute atatasya bhayam bhavati ityadi shrute he. Taitriya mantra said, one who makes even a little difference. Ut aram antaram kurute. Then what will happen? Atha tasya bhayam bhavati. Otherwise, abhaya hetu, same Ishwara is abhaya hetu. Once aikya is known, ityadi shrute tasmat aham brahma asmi iti eva tvam vijaniya. So tvam vijaniya, you know the fact as you are brahma. Aham brahma asmi iti. So Acharya is teaching how you should have the vritti. You should have the vritti of aham brahma asmi. Even when Tattvamasi is taught, vritti in the Shishya should be aham brahmasmi, not Tattvamasi. Therefore, aham brahmasmi is the culmination. Because you see, Tattvamasi, tvam is, when tvam is told to someone, he understands, he receives this as aham. He or she should understand it as aham. That is a language. Thereby, when Tattvamasi is said, it is received as aham tadasmi, and that tad is brahma. Further, aham brahma iti jnanam kasya iti vicharaha. Now the question is, aham brahma. If you say aham brahma, whose jnana is it? Now this is a question which lingers on, you know. Because this question, pre-jnana, it lingers on. Post-jnana, the question drops. So people have this question as to if everything other than Brahma is mithya, then Jiva is mithya. Jiva is Chidabhasa is Mithya, which is the main meaning of Jiva. But Jiva Brahmaiva Napara, where Jiva is Chaitanya, which is the Mukhyartha in fact, not in Laukika Prayoga. The Aham, which is used in Laukika as the Tvampada Vachyartha, that has a general meaning as not even Chidabhasa, it has the meaning of the entire Shariratraya, basically Sharira itself. People barely know that there is something other than the Shariratraya. They don't even know the Shariratraya, in fact. They know only one Sharira. But the Lakshartha is the Mukhyartha really of Atma. So Aham should lead to Brahma. Now, if it leads to Brahma, then whose jnana is it? Jiva as Chidabhasa is Mithya. Jiva as Chaitanya is Brahma. Who is the samsari? Chidabhasa is the samsari, which is answered here. Jiva is samsari. But elsewhere in Gita, Bhashya, Puro Pakshi asks, who is this? I think in the Kshetra Kshetra Yoga, there the Puro Pakshi asks the question about the setup. Bandha Moksha, how is this possible? If there is Aikya, who has this Jnana? So the question is, who is the one who knows this? There Bhagavan Bhashyakara does not answer Idam Ittham. He says, you the questioner has samsara, you the questioner will have moksha. Now who that you is, that has to be inquired into by the questioner. If you say you do not know, then the question is invalid. If you say you know, then you already know the answer. Again, the question is invalid. That is why Bhagavan Bhashyakara does not answer this question. When you inquire, since this doubt lingers on, the analysis is taken here. Tattva Drishti has this question. Because he has inquired into it and knows that Chidabhasa is Mithya. Mithya actually cannot have samsara, cannot have anything. And Satya can anyway have no samsara because Satya is Asanga, Tattva is Asanga, Brahma cannot have samsara. So Bandha Moksha both are Mithya. Then this Aham Brahma iti Jnanam, when the Guru says Aham Brahma Asmi iti eva Tvam Vijaniya, then this Tvam he wants to know. If I want to know this, who is that I really, who has this jnana, aham brahma? Is it me the Chidabhasa or me the Chaitanya? The answer may seem obvious. Oh, Chidabhasa, I know the answer, it is Chidabhasa. But there is an issue if you say Chidabhasa. Tattva Drishti can see this. He says, Tattva Drishti Prashnaha, He Swamin, aham brahma iti jnanam kasya jayate. For whom is this knowledge born? Jnana. Krupaya etan me vaktum arhasi iti. You ought to tell me who has this jnanotpatti, aham brahma. What is the idea backing? Prashnasya ayam abhiprayaha. Aham brahma iti jnanam kim kutasthasya jayate uta chidabhasa vishishta buddhehe. Is it this complex that gets the assemblage? Chidabhasa Vishishta Buddhi, other than Chaitanya, where Chaitanya is there definitely as a reflection, otherwise reflection won't be possible. So Chidabhasa Vishishta Buddhehe Jayate Uta Kutastasya Chaitanyasya Jayate. Yadi Kutastasya Iti Uchyate Tada Vikari Syat Kutastha. If the Jnana takes place in Kutastha Chaitanya, then wherever Jnana takes place, Adhikarana, he'll become the Adhikarana, and Adhikarana is a Karaka, therefore there is a Vikara. So Kutastha Chaitanya will become Vikari. Vikari. Dirga because Pullinga. Kutastha will become Vikari. Vikaraha Asya Asthiti Vikari. Matuparthaini. He will have Vikara. Whereas Kutastha Chaitanya is not a Vikari. Avikari has been said all over. So Kutastha cannot have Jnanutpatti. Yadi Chidabhasa Vishishta Buddhi Rityuchate, Tarihi Tasya उत्पद्यमानं अहं ब्रह्म इति ज्ञानं भ्रमरूपं स्यात्. देन व्हाट विल हैपन इफ द चिदाभासा हैज नॉलेज दैट अहं ब्रह्म, देन चिदाभासा कैन नेवर बी ब्रह्म एज इट इज. चिदाभासा इज मिथ्या. ऐक्य देर कैनॉट बी ऐक्य सामानाधिकरण. देर कैनॉट बी सामानाधिकरण कैनॉट बी ऐक्य सामानाधिकरण. It has to be Bada Samana Adhikaran. I mentioned this earlier. Yadi Chidabhasa Vishishta Buddhehe Aham Brahma Iti Jnanam Utpadyate Chet. Then what will happen? Tasya Utpadyamanam Jnanam Aham Brahma Iti. Oh, I am Brahma. That Jnana will be Brahmarupa. Why so? Just like, he gives an example, just like Rajju thinking that I am Sarpa. That is the kind of Brahma. Brahma. Garju can never become Sarpa. So it is. The same popular example is used to explain. Kutastho Brahma Chaiti Ubhayam Ekameva. Kutastha Brahma. Kutastha and Brahma are two names. Nama Matra Bheda Asti. Kutastha Brahma Cha Ityubhayam Ekameva. Kutastha Chaitanya Brahma Chaitanya. What is the difference? They are just names. Different names given to same Chaitanya, and those names cannot do any justice because Brahma Chaitanya, that is never a Vachyartha of any word. So Nama Krita Bheda is anyway invalid. There is only Abheda between the two. There are no two. In fact, to say Abheda between the two means both are one. There is no word both possible also. There is only one. That is the idea there. Abhasa, however, Abhasastu Kalpitatvad Brahmano Bhinna. Kalpita Abhasa is different from Brahma. Kalpita Abhasa cannot be Brahma. You cannot imagine someone is like something and that someone really becomes that. That is not possible. I cannot imagine that I am, you know, I am a king. I won't become a king just by imagining. So, Kalpita king is definitely not same as me, is different. Iti pragabhitam bhavata, and you have said that Abhasa is not, is Kalpita. And Kalpitatvat, karana brahmana bhinnaha abhasaha. Tasmad brahmano anyasya chidabhasasya brahmatvena jnanam brahmarupam eva syat. And what is Kalpita? If you think Kalpita is one as the Adhisthana, then that thinking is invalid. That Jnana is what? It is Brahma, it is not Prama. Therefore, the second option also seems invalid. Yatha sarpad vilakshanayam rajvam sarpajnanam jayamanam bhrantirupam eva tadvat. If we consider with respect to Rajju, in the example of Rajju Sarpa, Rajju seen as Sarpa, whereas Sarpa is Kalpita, then that Sarpa Jnana is Mithya, it is Brahma. Knowledge is definitely born. Sarpa Jnanam, Utpadyamanam, Jayamanam. Still what it is? Bhranti Rupam, Natu Prama Rupam. Tadvat. Similarly, this is a similar case. Chidabhasa thinking that I am Brahma is not possible. People will laugh in your face. You limited Jiva is limitless Brahma. At the Upadhi level, it cannot be. Evam cha chidabhasa sahita buddhir jayamanam aham brahma iti jnanam na yatharthanubhava rupam bhavet. It is not yatharthanubhava rupa, but it is Brahma. Kintu Brahma rupam eva syat. Therefore, second option seems invalid. Aham Brahma iti jnanasya bhramatvangi kare. Then once you take the Aham Brahma jnana as Brahma, why is it Brahma? Because both options are invalid. Aham Brahma is not possible for Chaitanya. That jnanotpatti is not possible for Kutastha Chaitanya. It is not even possible. It is possible for the Chidabhasa, but it is Brahma, it is not Prama. And being Brahma, the Jnana itself is Brahma. Aham Brahma iti Jnanasya Brahmatvangikare. Once you accept that as Brahma, what will happen? तेन ज्ञानेन मिथ्याभूतं जगन् निवर्तेत. मिथ्याभूत जगत विल नॉट गो बाय भ्रम ज्ञान. यथार्थ ज्ञानादेव ही मिथ्या भ्रम निवृत्तिर दृष्टा. We have always seen wherever there is Brahma, it goes only by Yatharta Jnana, Yatharta Anubhava. Once you know Rajju as Rajju, then alone Brahma Rupa Sarpa Jnana Nivarteta would go away. However, Yatharta Jnana isn't there in this case. Brahma Rupa Jnana is there. Where is the possibility of Mukti? जगत् न निवर्तेत. रज्जु तत्वज्ञान मिथ्या सर्प निवृत्तिवत. रज्जु तत्वज्ञान नॉट भ्रम ज्ञान बट रज्जु तत्व. इफ यू नो रज्जु एज दंडा देन सर्प विल नॉट गो अवे. भ्रम विल नॉट गो अवे. यू मे हैव अनदर भ्रम बट इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू लीड टू मुक्ति. दैट इज द आइडिया. तस्माद् आभास विशिष्ट बुद्धेः अहम् ब्रह्म इति ज्ञानम् जायते इति एतद् वचनम् अनुपपन्नम् एवेति. Therefore, चिदाभास विशिष्ट बुद्धि cannot have अहम् ब्रह्म ज्ञान as यथार्थ ज्ञान. ज्ञान मेन आइडिया ऑफ ज्ञान इज इट शुड बी यथार्थ ज्ञान नॉट एनीथिंग इन एवरीथिंग. यू ऑलरेडी हैव ज्ञान. इफ समवन आस्क्स यू हू आर यू, यू ऑलरेडी हैव ज्ञान विच इज नॉट यथार्थ. Thereby, yatharta jnana is apekshita. So, pragukta prashnasya uttaram kim? That is given here, abhasasya saptavasthaha. Here, quite a detailed analysis is done. Abhasa chaitanya has seven avasthas. What are those avasthas? Aham brahma iti jnanam abhasasya eva. First, he has clarified. अहम् ब्रह्म इति ज्ञानम् कूटस्थस्य न भवति. कस्य भवति इति चेत् चिदाभासस्य एव. आभास चैतन्य इज चैतन्य इव चैतन्यम्. चैतन्यम् इव चैतन्यम्. इट इज नॉट रियली चैतन्य. सो दैट मिथ्या आभास विल हैव दिस ज्ञान. हे सौम्य शृणु इदानीं मया उच्यमानः चिदाभासस्य सप्तावस्थाः. दीज आर दी सेवन स्टेट्स मया उच्यमानः. आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट दी. लिसन टू दी सेवन स्टेट्स दैट दी चिदाभास गोस थ्रू और रिमेन्स इन. आसु अवस्थासु मध्ये न काप्य अवस्था चेतनस्य कूटस्थस्य संभवति. कूटस्थ चैतन्य कैनॉट हैव दीज अवस्था. सो दीज अवस्थाज आर चिदाभासस्य एव. अहम् ब्रह्म इति ज्ञानम् अपि आसु सप्तावस्थासु मध्ये पञ्चम्याम् अवस्थायाम् अन्तर्गतम्. इन् दि फिफ्थ स्टेट यू विल हैव अहम् ब्रह्म इति ज्ञान. दैट ज्ञानावस्था ज्ञानोत्पत्ति टेक्स प्लेस फॉर चिदाभास एंड दैट इज दि फिफ्थ स्टेट ऑफ दिस सो कॉल्ड जीवा चिदाभास. तासाम् अवस्थानाम् नामानि. सो इट इज कोटेड इन अ श्लोक. अज्ञानम् आवृति सम्यक् विक्षेपश्च परोक्षधीः अपरोक्षं मतिशोक हतिस्तृप्तिर् निरंकुशा इति. सो अज्ञानम् आवृतिः सम्यक् विक्षेपः च परोक्षधीः अपरोक्षं मतिः शोक हतिः तृप्तिः निरंकुशा. सो निरंकुशा तृप्तिः आनंदम्. So what are the seven states? Ajnanam. Ajnanam is the first avastha. Ajnana avastha. Then avarana avastha. Avaranam is mentioned in the shloka as avrutihi. Avrutihi is avaranam. Samyag vikshepa. Very well grounded in the assumption that there is prapancha. So vikshepa projected becomes real. There is prapancha in the sense that I have sharira. That is bhranti. Vikshepa, samyak vikshepa is bhranti. Then parokshadhihi, parokshadhyana takes place. Brahmasti, there is Brahma. That is parokshadhyana. Then aparokshamatihi is aparokshadhyanam. This is the aparokshadhyana avastha. This is the panchama avastha, which is talked about here. पंचम्याम अवस्थायाम अंतर्गतम किम अहम ब्रह्म इति ज्ञानम अहम ब्रह्म ज्ञान अपरोक्ष ज्ञान ब्रह्म अस्ति तद अस्ति दैट इज परोक्ष ज्ञानम दैट इज द फोर्थ अवस्था देन दैट विल नॉट गिव मुक्ति फिफ्थ अवस्था इज मुक्ति कारक अपरोक्ष ज्ञानम व्हाट इज द फल ऑफ अपरोक्ष ज्ञान व्हेन इट बिकम स्थिर शोकनाशः विच इज कॉल्ड एज शोकहति शोकहति इज शोकनाश शोकनाश मीन्स वॉट शोक इज अनर्थ नोबडी वॉन्ट्स दिस दुख निवृत्ति आत्यंतिक दुख निवृत्ति एज वी हैव सीन इन द इंट्रोडक्टरी सेक्शन फर्स्ट चैप्टर अनर्थ निवृत्ति इज शोकनाश और अदरवाइज कॉल्ड एज आत्यंतिक दुख निवृत्ति देन दुख निवृत्ति इज नॉट सफिशियंट वन नीड्स आनंद which is swarupa ananda that will manifest as soon as there is dukkha nivritti by real jnana not dukkha nivritti by some other measure we say dukkha is gone because one is diverted towards something else like a child the child being carried by the mother is happy then the mother puts him down for a bit and goes to work in the kitchen the child begins to cry that shokanasha will it take place so somebody around you know is crying the child is crying for the mother but then shows a toy the child likes to play with the toy and is happy for the moment has forgotten the mother for a bit but then it is not atyantika dukkha nivritti After a bit of play with the toy, suddenly he remembers the mother and starts crying again. So what happens then? That is shokanasha. It is temporary. Not such kind of a shokanatha. No, shokanasha. This is anartha nivritti, atyantika dukkha nivritti. Child will be happy only with the mother. So therefore, the real swarupa being known, which causes shokanasha, that will cause ananda prapti also. Atiharshaha. Atiharsha is In the shloka is tripti nirankusha tripti. That tripti is untainted, not tainted by vishaya, not by any toys. It is your real vishayas are nothing but toys. That's why child example is to show that the child outgrows the toys when the child grows up. Then the vishayas are like toys. As an adult, as a grown-up, if we are looking at vishayas as sources of anandas, it is similar to the source of ananda being the toy for the child. As the child grows up, he outgrows the toys. Similarly, we should outgrow the vishaya sukha and take to atma sukha. That is niratishaya ananda praptihi. इति दीज आर दि सप्तावस्थास अज्ञान आवरणयोः स्वरूपम नाउ अज्ञान हियर अज्ञान एंड आवरण आर दि फर्स्ट टू दीज आर दि अवस्थास दैट दि जीवा हैज अज्ञान इज अवर मूल संपत्ति बिकॉज ऑफ विच वी टेक टू संसार वी आर बॉर्न ड्यू टू दिस एंड व्हाट इज दिस फर्स्ट कार्य आवरण इट वेल्स अवर स्वरूप दैट इज दि फर्स्ट शक्ति सो आवरण इज ऑल्सो देर Bhranti continues to be there in various janmas, different types of bhrantis. So, vikshepa also continues as the second shakti of ajnana. Once the jnana takes place, then brahma, there is something called as atma, brahma. That is paroksha jnana. Once that brahma is known as oneself, it counters the ajnana completely and then It becomes Sakshatkara. That is the avastha of the jiva. Then that leads to the sixth and the seventh stages of phala. He somya aham brahmana jani iti vyavahare karanam ajnanam. When I say that I do not know the no brahma, I don't know brahma, then That is a complete ajnana avastha, which is the case of most of the people. Charvakas, aham brahma na jane. इति व्यवहार कारणम अज्ञानम बिकॉज अहम ब्रह्मज्ञ न जाने देर अहम द मेन मीनिंग ऑफ अहम इटसेल्फ इज ब्रह्म एनी वन हु नोज अहम ए सेपरेट फ्रॉम ब्रह्म रियली डज नॉट नो ब्रह्म दैट इज ए कल्मिनेशन इन द फिफ्थ अवस्था टेकिंग अवे दैट अज्ञान एंड लैंडिंग ऑन अहम ब्रह्म बट हियर अहम ब्रह्म इति न जाने इट इज नॉट सेड अहम ब्रह्म न जाने डज नॉट नो ब्रह्म एट ऑल चार्वाकास कारण फॉर दैट इज अज्ञान ब्रह्म नास्ति न भाति इति व्यवहार कारणम तु आवरणम सो इफ आई से आई डू नॉट नो ब्रह्म दैट इज जनरल अज्ञान बट इफ यू इंक्वायर इन टू द रियल पार्ट ऑफ अज्ञान द रियल कॉज वॉट इज द पार्ट विच इज द शक्ति विच इज वर्किंग फॉर माई अज्ञान वॉट एग्जैक्टली इज हैपनिंग इन द अज्ञान ऑल्सो द इफेक्ट ऑफ अज्ञान manifest as I do not know. There if you inquire into it, O Brahma nasti, aham Brahma na jane, I do not know. But is Brahma there or not if you inquire, then Brahma nasti. Why? Na bhati. Asti chet, bhasate. Mama tu na bhati, ityataha Brahma nasti. If Brahma is there, I would have known it. I don't know Brahma. Therefore, Brahma is not there. So, if you inquire further in the Ajnana Avastha, then one knows there is Avarna. Brahma nasti na bhati iti vyavahara karanam tu avarnam. The veiling is the reason. Whereby, Brahma isn't there. I do not know Brahma. Brahma isn't there. Brahma doesn't shine forth. When we say ghata, ghataha asti, ghataha bhati, then ghata is there and ghata is visible. There is cognition of ghata. Ghatam aham janami. That is possible only when ghataha bhati chet. Only when ghata shines forth as ghata, I can say ghatam aham janami. So avarnena dvividho vyavaharah bhavati. There are two types of vyavahara with avarna. Yataha ajnanasya shakti dvayam vartate. Ajnana has avarna shakti and vikshepa shakti. Therefore, it causes two types of vyavaharas. One is what? Tatra eka shakti hi asatva padika. Anya abhana padika. One makes you think that it isn't there. Something isn't there. Another shakti makes you lose sight of it. The part of Shakti, Avarna. Avarna itself causes it, not Vikshepa. Avarna makes you think that Brahma isn't there. Asatva. Brahma nasti. Then Abhana. Abhana apadika, it gives you Abhana. Even if it is there, it is veiled. Therefore, you say, no, I can't see. I don't know what it is. There is no way to cognize Brahma. Ubhayor api shaktyo avarnam ityeva sadharanam nam. Generally, both are called as avarna. Meaning, nasti na bhati. That is the idea. Brahma nasti, Brahma na bhati. Both put together are generally called as avarna. Vastu nasti iti pratiti hetu bhuta shakti asatvapadiketi. Vastu na bhati iti pratiti hetu bhuta shakti hi abhanapadiketi. Cha uchyate. So, vastu nasti. Brahma nasti, vastu nasti, generally also any vastu nasti. That is called as that shakti. In within the avarna shakti also division is made. That is asatvapadika shakti. And the other shakti which says, it makes you think that vastu na bhati. Why, you know, cannot cognize this vastu. Pratiti hetu bhuta is. Not I cannot cause. Vastu na bhati is vastu does not reveal itself. In the mind it is. The end result is aham brahma na jane. But vastu na bhati means vastu isn't there and therefore it isn't available for cognition. That is the idea. Not I don't see, it is not available. Na bhati. Not for me, for anyone. Nasti ityatah na bhati. Shashashrungavat. Like Sashashrunga, it is not there at all. Therefore, it is not seen, not by me alone, not by anyone. No one can see it since it doesn't exist. No one can hear it since it doesn't exist. No one can taste it, smell it, or touch it since it doesn't exist. Iti pratiti hetu bhuta shakti abhanapadiketi cha uchyate. Ittham brahmanasti iti vyavahara karanam ajnanasya asatvapadika shaktireva. So brahmanasti, here generally vastu nasti. In the context, brahmanasti. That is caused by the ajnana shakti, which is asatvapadika. It makes you think it isn't there. And it doesn't reveal itself. It is not available for cognition. Brahmana bhati iti vyavahara karanam ajnanasya abhanapadika shaktireva. The second part of ajnana shakti is abhanapadika. It makes us think that Brahma isn't available at all to be cognized. An anayoho shaktyoho sadharanam abhida avarnamiti. Generally, it is called as avarna. So, avarna shakti, when you see, we should understand as nasti nabhati. That is the resultant. Bhranti sarupam. So, vikshepa. What is this swarup of vikshepa? Kutasthe bhasamana janmadi samsaro vede bhranti ityuchyate. In Veda Vedanta Shastra, what is meant by bhranti? Bhranti means kutasthe bhasamana janmadi samsaraha. One sees in kutastha chaitanya, which is the real atma, me, aham. Unto aham, samsara being seen. Bhasamana, there is a pratiti of samsara. I have samsara. I am a samsari. I have samsara means samsara mama asti. Mama pratyagatmana asti. Kutastha chaitanyasya mama. Samsara asti. Iti yad bhanam. Bhasamana janmadi samsara. Samsara is nothing but janmadi shadvikara. All these are there for me. That idea is called as bhrantihi in Veda Vedanta. Ayameva samsara shoka shabdena pyuchyate. Samsara is nothing but shoka. Therefore, shoka shabda also means samsara. Meaning, shoka is also there for me. I grieve because I have lot of grief. Tatra komohka shoka ekatva anupashyataha tarati shoka matmavit. Vidyate hrade grantis chidyante sarva samshyakshiyante chasya karmani tasmin drushte paravare mattav parataran nanyat kinchidasti dhananjaya na kartruttam na karmani lokasya srijati prabhu ajnane navrutanyanam tena muyyanti jantavaha vasudeva sarvamiti samahatma sudurlabaha ityadi shruti smriti vihi samsarasya atmaikatva jnanamatra nivartyatva bodhikabhihi Brahma Matratvam Bodhitam. Shruti and Smritis, various Upanishads and Gita Shastra show Brahma Matratvam, the idea here of Kutasthe Janmadi Samsara Asti. I have Samsara, I am a Samsari, that is Brahma Matram. How do you know? Brahma Matratvam Bodhitam. Kaihi or Kabhi, here Strilingi, therefore Kabhi, by all these samsarasya atmaikatva jnana matra nivartyatva bodhikabhihi. By those Shruti and Smriti vachanas which tell you that samsara will go away. Will go away, nivartya. Samsara is nivartya. Samsara si nivartyattvam. Samsara has nivartyattvam. Meaning samsara will go away. How will samsara go away? Jnana matrena. Jnana matrena nivartyattvam. Samsarasya. What is that jnana? Atmaikatva jnana. Atmaikatva jnana matrena samsarasya nivartyattva bodhika bhihi, shruti bhihi, smriti bhihi, Bodhitam. What is Bodhitam? What is taught? What is revealed? Brahma Matratvam. How odadi shruti is now? Tatra ko moha ka shokaha ekatvam anupashyataha. For one who is ekatvam anupashyan. One who is seeing ekatva. Anupashyan means jnana. There is anu, anupashchat. Upadesha, upadesham anu. So, shrutyacharya upadesham anu, anu paschat paschataha tasya sadhakasya ekatvam. Ekatvam, as taught by ekatvam anupashyataha tasya, tasya ya avastha, which avastha he reaches, that pancham, saptama stage actually, tatra ko moha ka shokaha, sixth stage there, ko moha ka shokaha. That will be the phala. What kind of moha will he have? What kind of shoka is possible? Says the Ishavasya Upanishad. This is not to be answered. Tatra ko moha means nasti, moha nasti. Kas shoka means shoka nasti. One who has aikya jnana cannot have moha and shoka. Kaimutaka nyaya is used there. Tarati shoka matmavit says Chandogya Saptamodhyaya. Narada Muni says, I have a lot of grief, but I have heard Tarati Shoka Matmavit. I want Atma Jnana. I do not have Atma Jnana. I have every bit of Jnana imaginable. The list is unheard of. That kind of list is unheard of, impossible in multiple Janmas put together. Even if you have to imagine, it is not possible. That kind of unheard of Jnana also. The listing itself is unheard. There are many things within which one person may not have heard completely, let alone having it. Narada has all such vidyas, but still he says, I don't have Atma Jnana. And I want Atma Jnana, therefore he comes to Sanat Kumara, Atma with Shokam Tarati. So Atma Jnana, Atma, knowing Atma, one transgresses Shoka, therefore Samsara Brahma, Samsara is Brahma. Then Mundaka Upanishad says, Vidyate Hridaya Granthi. Hridaya Granthi there is Avidya Granthi. That is cut asunder. And Chidyante Sarva Samshayaha. All the doubts are shattered. Kshiyante Chasya Karmani. All the karmas will go away. Except for Prarabdha, of course. Sanchita, all the Sanchitas and Agami karmas will go away. When? Tasmin drishte, paravare drishte sati, parecha avare, brahmani drishte sati, sati saptami. When parabrahma and avarabrahma, nirguna brahma and saguna brahma are known. As what? As oneself. Then all these are results. Therefore, hridaya granthi goes away. Then avidya karya will go away, samsara will go away, sarva samshayas go away. Karmas, punya papa goes away. Then, where is shoka possible? Samsara is not possible. Therefore, samsara is bhranti. If it is real, it will never go away. Mattah parataram na anyat kinchidasti dhananjaya. He dhananjaya. So, Arjuna who won over dhana by going around everywhere collecting dhana for the huge Rajasuya Yajna that they had planned, Yudhishthira had planned. He got the name Dhananjaya because he collected dhana for that. Winning over many kings. Either you give dhana, accept and give dhana, or you fight with me. That is the idea there. And then he won over. Some kings offered their, they took Yudhishthira as the emperor and offered. Oh, you rule our kingdom also is part of your samrajya. Otherwise, you fight. And they failed. Therefore, they had to give. So, either taken away by force by winning over dharma itself. Force in the sense not as in, the way we had Akramana. But this is how it is explained as Dhananjaya meaning there for Arjuna. Krishna tells him, Matta Paratam Nanyat Kinchidasti. Matta, other than me, Panchamyarthe Tasil. Other than me means other than Atma. Krishna is not talking about his upadhi. Parataram nasti. Nanyat kinchir asti. There is nothing else superior to Atma. Thereby, samsara has to be dukkha. Na kartrutvam na karmani lokasya srijati prabhu. So, prabhu na srijati. Kartrutva bhoktrutva. All these are imagined, therefore bhranti. Samsara is bhranti. One becomes a karta taking samsara as real, jagat as real. Then does karma to meet the ragatvesha becoming a karta, and thereby all this is not done by the Prabhu. Ajnanena avrutam jnanam. There is avarana due to ajnana, which is its shakti, and then jnana, once it is jnana, chaitanya is covered, tena jantavaha muhyanti. Not true only for human beings, jantavaha. They also, everyone, every prani undergoes moha. Otherwise, moha itself tells you that once the ajnana goes away, jnanena nivrutti bhavati chet, then what will happen? Na muhyanti. One is free, samsara is bhranti. Vasudeva sarvamiti samhatma sudurlabha. One who knows this is shushtu durlabha. Very difficult to, kaschid dhira attains it, so very difficult to attain this state as what? Vasudeva sarvamiti. Everything is Brahma Ishvara. That kind of person himself will become Mahatma, and it is very difficult to attain that state, even to know such Mahatmas. Ityadi Shruti Smriti Bihi Samsarasya Atmaikatva Jnana Matra Nivartyatva Bodhika Bihi Brahma Matratvam Bodhitam. So samsara being Brahma has been mentioned here. So samsarasya nivartyatva bodhikabhi samsarasya brahma matratvam. It can be reused here. Samsarasya brahma matratvam bodhitam. Samsara is Brahma. We'll see the 194th in the next part. Sukhan nityam saprakasham vyapakan namun adhishthanam buddhya buddhyam buddher dhukyatna nirvana param sarvedanta vidyam pratyakparam tadevaham namutvam nitmi nishitamatihi. Any questions? I think the work is so elaborate, there are no questions. There is nothing left to doubt. It's quite elaborate, and therefore there are barely any doubts. If there are any, they are clarified in the Tippana. Tippana can raise to more doubts if we are not trained enough. But otherwise, I think the work is quite elaborate, not to leave any doubts. Therefore, Vichara Sagara, very nicely named. Appropriately named. Okay, namaste.
Namaste, Guruji.
Namaste.